Hello student, today we are going to study political science. Class 9, chapter 1, the name is What is Democracy? Why Democracy? This is the fourth part of the video. Earlier in the three videos, what we have discussed, what is democracy? We discussed about its define, what is the define, then the simple meaning, then the different key features of the democracy, the ruler, the election, the people and the forms of the government. Then later we discuss about in the second video that the all the powers towards the elected leaders only. It should be free and the fair election. It should be one vote, one person, one value. Then we'll discuss more about the different features like of the why there is a need of a democracy. Then we discuss about the summary of the definition. Then we discuss about the argument between the students, like some of the people have the some different students have the different ideas. Some were the honest leaders, some were the leaders that all the powers are said to them only. Some want the sincere, or you can see the honest office, leaders. Some want that the why there is a need of a democracy. Something that is there a need of a democracy, or the thought that all the countries having the democracy. If the few countries are there, they are not having the democracy. So they did the protest, they did the reforms, they did the, you can say, the revolution. Then they have the, what you can say, that they have now, they are having the democratic form of the government. So far of this we have discussed this. We are in on this topic, that the arguments against the democracy, which we are going to learn more further. Then in today's video, what we have to discuss about the argument against the democracy, then the arguments for the democracy, and the broader meaning of the democracy, means the detailed meaning of the democracies, which we are going to learn according to the different countries and their different perspectives, that what they want to say, what the ideas they have, what kind of changes want to see in their own country. So these are the certain things which we are going to discuss in this chapter. So start from the page number 32. There are some of the other arguments against the democracy that you can think of. Which of this argument applies mainly to the democracy? Which of this can apply to the misuse of any form of the government? Yes, there are these some, you can say, the party where they used to do the arguments, and some of the leaders are that they misuse their power. They thought that now I am the elected leader, now I am in the majority, so I have all the rules, whatever I want to do, I can do it. So some of the leaders in the some countries, they used to misuse their power. Which of this do you agree with it? Yes, somehow we can agree with it. Clearly, democracy is not a magical solution for all the problems. Yes, that is true. That is, okay, democracy is not a magical solution for all the problems in the particular country. It has not ended the poverty in our country. If we talk about India, it doesn't end the poverty. And in the other parts of the world, that is utmost fact, being the democracy in our country, we didn't end the poverty. So if it is the magical solution they have, so they can do it, but it's not the magical solution. Democracy is the form of government only ensure that the people take their own decisions, that that is true. Or you can say the first point, if we come to think about in the democracy, the people can take their own decisions. They do not have to rely upon or depend upon any other person, that you can take a decision for us. This does not guarantee that the decision will not be good. People can make mistake. Yes, the decision should be not good. The people can make mistake. Involving the people in this decision does lead to delay in the decision making. Yes, if we used to involve the people to make any of the decision, it used to delay the decision. Means, agar hume koi decision lena hota, logo ka involvement, agar hume unki ideas janne hote, to kabhi kabhi aise hota hai, decision kya hota hai, delay hota hai. We are talking about the against, we are not talking about the for. We are talking against because we are discussing in the argument purpose. Then in the argumenting or in the debatable form, it is also the true for the democracy leads to the frequent changes in the leadership. Yes, the democracy leads to the need of frequent changes, because which I already said that, like, according to the time changes, according to the technology, according to the people perception, according to the people's idea, their beliefs, their views, we have to change the scenario, because we want a nation to be live in a peace and harmony. for the development purpose, to the boost in the economy. So these are the certain things which we have to see in our democratic country, where the people have all the beliefs, the people have all the idea what the changes they want to see in our democratic country. Because in the democratic country, we elect the leaders because according to our perception, according to our ideas, according to our beliefs. So these are the things, these are the certain scenario where we have seen the different countries. Just if we talk about the Portugal, if we talk about the Mexico, if we talk about the US, if we talk about India, each and every leader or each and every, you can talk about the voters, they have the rights. They, according to which year, like if we talk about the India, every 5 years we can give our vote. If we talk about the Mexico, every 6 years they used to give their vote. If we talk about the US, they used to give the vote every 4 years. So they have this certain, if like if the particular government, they used to involve the particular person, so it might have that it used to delay it. If they want to take the decision, it used to be a delay, or you can say, like if they want to take the decision, maybe in a month, it is to delay by the 6 months, maybe it takes 12 months, maybe it takes 1.5 months. So these are the certain things which are the drawbacks of the democracy. Sometimes this kind of setback the big decision and affect the government efficiency. Yes, sometimes they take the big decision and it used to affect the government. Then this argument shows that a democracy is for a kind we can see may not be ideal form of the government. Like if you want to see, like these are the points, if they are in the government, so we can't find the ideal government. Agar is tarah ke sare points honge to hame ideal government nahi milegi, ek achhi government nahi milegi. Then we go for further. Real question we face is different. Is democracy better than the other form of the government? That are there for us to choose them. Now we come towards the next topic of this chapter, is that the argument for the democracy, that China famine in of 1958 till 1961 was the worst recorded famine in the world history. So think about in the year 1958 to till 1961, it is the worst affected country at that time in the world history. Nearly 3 crore people died in the famine. Think about it, nearly 3 crore people due to the famine, they used to die. During those kind of Indian economic condition was not much better than the China. That is true, that because after the independence, in 1991, our economy used to boom, or you can say it used to change. Starts from the 1991 till the, you can say the 2020. Earlier, our economy is like in the form of the crippled situation, not in a very good way. Then, yet the India did not have the famine of the kind the China had. Yes, it is true that the China, which they had the famine, this kind of famine, we didn't affected our country in any of the famine. If you talk about after the independence, certain kind of situation we didn't find that. Now to come the economics thing, that it was the result of different government policy in the two countries. Yes, the different policy have, we are having the different two countries, that China is having their own policies and India is having their own policy. For the existence of the democracy in India, made the Indian government respond to the food scarcity in the way of the Chinese government did not. Yes, in India we are having the food scarcity, but in China they do not have the food scarcity. If you are thinking what the food scarcity is, means khane ki kami. Yes, hamare desh mein pehle thi, but China mein aise kabhi nahi hua. But if you think about the famine, famine kaise, because of like now after the number of years, they are having no rainfall, and due to that, they are not having any kind of vegetation, they are not doing any kind of agriculture. So on the basis of that, over the period of years, or you can say over the period of time, they affected by the famine, and nearly the 3 crores of the people used to die in 1958 to till 1961 in the China, which is the worst affected in the world history. They point out that the no large scale famine have ever taken place in the independent, in the democratic country. So they point out that the no large scale famine has ever taken place in the independent, in the democratic country. In China, to have the multi-party election. Multi-party election means not a single party they used to do the election. There are the multiple parties, like more than 2 or 3 parties, they used to contest their election, in which the particular people or the people used to elect their own representative, where they used to elect the from the particular leader, they belong to which party. In the China to have the multiple election and the opposition party, a press free to criticize the government, then so many people may not have the died in the famine. So like our India, China is having the multiple party form of the, you can say the multi-party. They are having the opposition party and they have the free media over there. The example brings out of the reason why the democracy is considered the best form of the government. Democracy is better than any other form of the government. That is true that because in the democracy we can change the government if they are not going according to the constitution, according to the right of the people, or according to the right of the citizen. We can change a government in every 5 years if they are not regulating, or they are not regulating on the way towards the people and towards the towards the development for the nation. So we can change the government. Democracy is better than any other form of government responding to the needs of the people. A non-democratic government may not can respond to the people. Yes, yes, some of the countries they are non-democratic and they are not thinking about the people, like what the peoples they want, what the changes they want, or what kind of development they want. They just think about their own purpose only, on selfishness, or you can talk about their own perception, because they want to live a luxurious life and the lavish life. They want to think their own self rather than for the people. If the rulers don't want to, they don't have to act according to the wishes of the people. A democracy requires that the rulers have to attend to the needs of the people. A democratic government is the better government because it is a more accountable form of the government. Yes, the democratic government is the kind of a very good government where it is more accountable. The accountable means where the whosoever the leader is there, whatever the decision, whatever the plans, whatever the initiative, what are the schemes and what are the laws they made, they have to come in front of the people and they have to say that this type of plan we have made, and we have regulated this, all the rules in towards all the nation, and you have to follow it. But this rules which we have made, it this is for the nation, this is for you, this is for the people, that you have to accept it and you have to regulate it all over the country with the peaceful and with the harmony. So we can call it as accountable, because whatever the initiative, the plan, the scheme, the law which is made by the government, they have to come in the front of the media and they have to explain it, that this kind of the rule which we have made, and you have to pass on this message towards the people that this is for them, this is not for the our purpose, this is for the nation, this is for the economy, and this is for the development. So these are the certain things which are done by the representative, the leader, or you can say by the ruling party. There is another reason why the democracy should lead to a better decision than any non-democratic government. There is the another reason that why the democratic government should be the better decision than any other government. Democracy is based on the consultation and the discussion. Yes, it is true that the democracy is on the base of the consultation and the discussion, because here the not only the single person, or you can say the single representative, take the decision. He has to discuss with the other peoples and their consultants. After that, by compiling all the ideas, then they can take a particular decision for the nation and for the people. A democratic decision always involves many persons. That is true that if you want to take a particular decision, if you think that I am the leader, I want to take the decision for the nation, I have to consult with the different people and and what the constitution states, that what the citizens rules they have, what the people preferences they have. According to that, I have to take the collective decision. So that it involves the many person, the discussion and the meeting. With the number of people put their heads together, they are able to point the possible mistake in any decision. There are true that if there is a particular meeting of the, there are the number of the people, they used to keep their mind together, they give their different decisions, that by which we come to know that like what are the drawbacks of my decision, if we correct out the particular decision, then we used to take out the correct decision. Like the means is that जब कोई गवर्नमेंट कोई डिसीजन लेने लेती है तो बहुत सारे लोग एक साथ आते हैं और उसमें वो अपने थॉट्स को डालते हैं कि इस डिसीजन में हमें क्या क्या चेंजेस करने चाहिए और क्या क्या कमी है उसको दूर करना चाहिए. जब एक साथ लोग जो ग्रुप में बैठ के जो डिसीजन लेते हैं, दैट डिसीजन शुड बी अ करेक्ट फॉर्म ऑफ द decision. This reduces the chances of race or the irresponsible decision. Yes, this is a kind of the decision where they can't discriminate on the basis of the race. We can talk about the colors and the irresponsible decision. It means वो decision कोई गलत नहीं लेते, काफी अच्छा decision भी लेते हैं. Thus, the democracy improves the quality of decision making. So, this is the, you can say, the positive point of a democracy. It can improve the condition, or you can say a leader's perspective to take a decision in a qualitative way. Now we come towards the fourth one, that is, sorry, the third argument, that democracy provides the method to deal with the differences and the conflict. Yes, democracies will help, and it's going to be helped in the past as well as in the future, as well as in the present, when we have to deal with the differences, that is between the lower caste or the upper caste, and we talk about the conflicts between the, you can say, the religious people, or we can talk about the in the different nations they used to conflict with each other. The democratic country going to be helping this, like that. In any society, people are bound to have difference of opinion and the interest. These differences are particularly sharp in the country like ours, which has an amazing social diversity. Like, we are so like amazing country that we are having the diversity, we are having the different religion, we have the different culture, we have the different customs, we have the different beliefs, we have the different race, we have the different, you can say, the state, we have the different place of birth, then which the people are some of the other time there are the some differences and there are the conflicts. Because you can think that aisa to nahi ki koi bhi country ho jisme kabhi jhagda nahi hota tha. So there are, like, agar hum apni India ki baat kare to yahan pe itni sari diversity hai ki dharmon ke beech, customs ke beech, beliefs ke beech, kabhi kabhi two nations ke beech ladai jhagde hote rehte. So these are the certain things which are also in the democracy, where we find this difference are the particular sharp in the country, like our, which has the emerging social diversity. People belong to the different regions, speak different languages, practice different religion, have the different castes. They look at the world very different, and they have the different preferences. The preferences of one group, one clan, clash with those of the other groups, which I already discussed about, that the upper class people or the upper class group clash with the lower class people, the lower class people group clash with the upper class people. So this, they used to conflict with each other whenever they have the conflict. We used to see every now and then in the news that this of the particular religion they used to fight with each other, or this of type of the particular caste people they used to fight with each other on the small issues. So how to resolve such conflict? The conflict can be solved by the brutal power. No, I don't think by the brutal power we can do it. By the, you can say, correct decision, we can change this particular conflict. How do we resolve such conflict? The conflict should be solved with the brutal power. I don't think we should do with the brutal power. We should take a correct decision, or we should take a particular action which can remove or which can solve their conflicts among this particular, whichever the group is more power with, will dedicated its terms, and other will have to accept that. But that would lead to the resentment and unhappiness. Different groups may not be able to live together for a long time. Such a way, democracy provides the only the peaceful solution to this problem, which I already said. The brutal, yani brutal ki tarah se decision lena ho to fir democracy ko koi zarurat hi nahi hai. Then we used to become the monarchical. Hame is tarah ka decision lena chahiye ki jo do dharmon ke beech ya jo caste ke group ke beech ladai hui hai, usko ek aisa decision lena chahiye ki dono ki jeet ho aur dono mein kya ho jaye. They used to become a friend rather than the enemies. So we have to take the peaceful solution in the problems. In the democracy, no one is the permanent winner. That is true, that none of the religion, none of the caste, none of the people, you can say, the permanent winner. Somehow, like, they are the winner, some are defeated. Like, those who are defeated, they used to become the winner, and the people who are winner, who they used to become, they used to be defeated somewhere now and then over the period of time. So no one in the permanent or no one in the loser. So no one in the, you can no one is the permanent winner, no one is the permanent loser. Different groups can live with one another peacefully. In a diverse country like India, democracy keeps our country together because we are in the diverse country. We have the different religion, we have the different languages, we have the different way of thinking, we have the different way of, you can say, to live our own life. We have the different cars, we have the different, say, the people, languages and the way of their living. So they are like, on the some of the small issues, they used to fight with each other. But in the democratic country, if we talk about what is the fascinating or what is the positive way of the democracy, is that we can take the collective decision or the peaceful decision where both the parties, or you can say that both the groups or both the castes or both the religion, they can become the friend rather than the enemy. No one is the permanent, you can say, the winner. No one is the permanent, the loser. Someone has the winner they are seeing the winner face, and someone is saying seeing the defeated face. Like if someone is saying the defeated face, so somehow they used to say the winner face as well. So they are, you can't say that they have this scenario where everywhere they can see the defeated scenario, or you can say the winner, he or she can, everywhere they can see the winner scenario. So this, they have the different perspective. The three arguments were about the effects of the democracy on the quality of the government in the social life. But the strongest argument for the democracy is not about what the democracy does. The three arguments about the effects of the democracy on the quality of the government and the social life. But the strongest argument of the democracy is not about what the democracy does to the government. यहाँ पे जो स्ट्रॉन्गेस्ट आर्गुमेंट किया गया वो किस बारे में किया गया है, डेमोक्रेसी सिर्फ कोई डेमोक्रेसी के लिए नहीं है, पर और एक गवर्नमेंट के लिए भी नहीं, ये हर तरह के लोगों को लिया गया है. इट यूज्ड टू टुक द गवर्नमेंट, इट यूज्ड टू टुक द पीपल, इट यूज्ड टू टुक द कॉन्स्टिट्यूशन, इट यूज्ड टू टुक द रूल्स, द नंबर ऑफ द थिंग्स यूज्ड टू टेक इट इन अ कलेक्टिव फॉर्म. इट इज अबाउट व्हाट द डेमोक्रेसी डज टू द सिटीजन. इवन इन द डेमोक्रेसी डज नॉट ब्रिंग अबाउट द बेटर डिसीजन एंड द अकाउंटेबल government, it is still better than the other forms of the government. Democracy enhances the dignity of the citizen. Means here we have to respect the dignity of the citizen. That doesn't mean the particular person is belong from the lower caste, but we can't give the respect to them. If the person belong from the any of the caste, any of the religion, we have to respect their dignity, their religion, and whatever the status they have. As we discuss about the democracy is the based on the principle of the political equality, on recognition that the poorest and the least educated have the same status as the rich and the educated. People are not subject to the ruler, they are the rulers themselves. Even when they make the mistake, they are responsible for their conduct. Final democracy, the argument is that the better the other forms of government, because it allows to correct his own mistake. Yes, that is true, that the forms of government, they allows the other people to do the argument on their government by which they can improve their mistake and they take the correct decision for the development of the country, which I have mentioned again and again. If this form of the government, they allow the other parties, or you can say the other people, to take out their mistake by which they can have their that particular party, that they can take the correct decision for the people, for the nation, and for the development of the country. As we show above, there are no guarantee that the mistake cannot be made out in a democracy. Yes, every now and then every political party used to take out their own mistake. No form of the government can guarantee that. Yes, none of the government can guarantee that we can't do, we didn't did any kind of mistake. Every party, when they used to come, somehow they did the mistake. And many mistakes, not somehow. The advantages in democracy is that such mistake cannot be hidden for the longer time. Yes, that is also true, that in the democratic form of the government, they can't hide or they can't hide their mistake for the longer time. By the media, by the people, they used to come in the media, and the common people or the ordinary people, they come to know what mistake has done by the government. This is the space of the for the public discussion or the mistake, and there is no room for the correction. Either the rulers have to change their decision. Yes, if they took the decision in the, you can say, the incorrect way, or they have to take the decision in the wrong way, so they can change it, their decision. The rulers can be changed. Yes, rulers can be changed. This cannot happen in the non-democratic country. In the democratic country, which I explained many a times, we can change our government, but in the non-democratic country, we can't change the government because it is ruled by the particular person, or you can talk about the particular king. Let us, the democracy cannot get us everything, is not a solution of all the problems. That is also a fact that what we come to know here, that democracy is not the solution of every problem. Yes, for the some problem there is the solution, but not of the every problem. Just like we saw about the poverty, by the that doesn't mean if we are the democratic country so we can remove the poverty from our country. So we see that despite of democracy, democracy in our country, we can't remove the poverty. But it is clear better than any other alternatives that we know. But it's clear that it, every other alternative we know, it offers the better change of good decision. We should take the good decision. It is likely to respect the people's own wishes and allow the different kinds of people to live together. Here, the because our country is the diverse, so each and every religion or each and every caste of the people, they used to can live in the society. Even when it fails to do some of these things, it all allows us the way of correcting its mistake and offer some dignity to all the citizens. It allows us the way of correcting the mistake. It allows us to correct a mistake and offer more dignity to the all the citizens. That is why the democracy is considered the best form of the government. So we used to consider the best form of the government. Now you can see this cartoon over here where the people used to give their idea according to their own perception. If we talk about the first one, that we the voters are angry and we are not going to give the tick anymore. The second one, that the liberals have been arrogant. The third one is that they have broken our trust in the government. Then the fourth one is stole our money, that they have taken our money. So on June 28th, we are going to do what changes do the best, and we are going to vote them back in. So this was the Ottawa citizen, the Canada cage cartoons that was taken in 30 May 2004. Now we talk about the further. This is the now the broader meaning of democracy, which we are going to discuss in the next part of the lecture. What is the broader meaning of the democracy? In this lecture, we have discussed about the argument against the democracy and the argument for the democracy. Most of the, so you can say the most of the problem, there are the solution in the democracy. We can change the government, we can change the decision over the period of time in the democratic form of government. But in the non-democratic form of government, we can't change the ruler, we can't change the king, we can't change the dictator, and we can't change the rule, because the final decision is taken by that particular ruler. That is the final. We can't change it, we can't do the protest against them. But in the democratic form of government, we can do certain kind of changes. Like if we talk about India, it is in diverse. The people of the different areas, the language they used to speak, the different dresses sense they have, the behavior knowledge they have, all the things are different. But we used to live in a society. Then they used to take the one thing is that if we give the all the power to the particular person, if they used to take the decision, it might have it used to take the correct decision, and somehow it used to take the bad decision as well. So in this case, when the number of the people or the number of the people he used to meet, he used to consult the other people. When all the people come together, they used to sit in a particular room, they used to do the meetings, and they used to take up what the good qualities in the particular plans and what are the drawbacks of their particular plans. But the sitting collectively, they used to take this decision in the correct form of way, by which they can what they can do, that they can't take the decision in the wrong form. They take the decision in the correct form, in the by thinking the way of for the citizen, for the country, for the nation, for the development to go further, and it will used to help us. So in the democratic country, there are the numerous of the solution for the problems, but some of the problems are there. We can't find the solution of each and every problem, or we can't say it is a magical form of the solution. Yes, there are the some solution, there are not some solution. In this case, we can say that the democracy is a very good form of the government rather than the non-democratic form of the government, because in the democracy, the leaders used to think about the people, the nation, and they have to look after the Indian territories. Each and every country and the leaders, they have to look after their country's people, their nation, their economy and territories, or you can say the borders. So in this case, we can say that they can listen to the people, their perception, their ideas, their belief. If there is to conflict with each other, so this is the duty of the government. They have to take the peaceful decision among the people, that they used to become a friend rather than the enemy. So there is no permanent winner. There is no permanent, you can say, the defeat. Some of the another way we can say that some of the person used to win and some of the person used to defeat. If the person who used to defeat used to win, and the person who used to won, he used to defeat some area now then. So I hope you like this video. Thank you.